No discussion of the 47% remarks. No discussion of immigration.
That's the president's fault.
No discussion of union rights. No discussion of women's rights. No discussion of Bain. No discussion of abortion. No discussion of Romney's jobs record in Massachusetts, even as he kept bringing up Massachusetts over and over again. Let's go to Chris Matthews for his response in Denver. Chris, what do you think?
Well, this tonight wasn't an MSNBC debate, was it? It just wasn't. It had none of the things you mentioned. It didn't mention all the key fighting points of this campaign. And certainly there was no Bobby Kennedy in the green room before Barack Obama came out tonight. I don't know what he was doing out there. He had his head down. He was enduring the debate rather than fighting it. Romney, on the other hand, came in with a campaign. He had a plan. He was going to dominate the time. He was going to be aggressive. He's going to push the moderator around, which he did effectively. He was going to relish the evening, enjoying it. Nothing to do with the words he spoke. Here's my question for Obama. I know he likes to say he doesn't watch cable television, but maybe he should start. I don't know how he let Romney get away with the crap he threw out tonight about Social Security. Listen to the stuff he got away with. He said, you know, emergency room. The latest thing we got from Romney, because he said so, is, you know what I want to do with people when they're poor? Shove them in the emergency room. Why didn't Obama say that? Why didn't he say that? You talk about Social Security, Medicare, and Medicare people. They're part of your 47%. You want to drop them from the list of eligible Americans. You don't have any care for these people. What are you talking about? We've got it on tape, Governor. We got it on tape what you think of these people. Don't come out here and pretend you care about old people because you met somebody at some campaign event. You've written off 47% of the country before you even started. Where was Obama tonight? He should watch, well, not just hardball racers should watch you, and should watch the Reverend Al, he should watch Lawrence. He would learn something about this debate. There's a hot debate going on in this country. You know where it's being held? Here, on this network, is where we're having the debate. We have our knives out. We go after the people and the facts. What was he doing tonight? He went in there disarmed. He was like, oh, wait, an hour and a half, I think I can get through this thing. And I don't even look at this guy. Where's Romney? I love the split screen. Staring at Obama, addressing him like the prey. He did it just right. I'm coming out an incumbent. I got to beat him. You got to beat the champ. And I'm going to beat him tonight. And I don't care what this this guy moderator, whatever he thinks he is, because I'm going to ignore him. What was Romney doing? He was winning.
He was winning tonight.
That was my thought. That was my thought. He was winning. If he does five more of these nights, forget it.
Well,
just a thought.
It puts the pressure on the president.
Obama should watch MSNBC. My last point. He will learn something every night on this show and all these shows that we're watching. This is like first grade to most of us. We know all this stuff.
Well, I was in front of a crowd last night in Denver, Colorado, and I know that they're stunned. I can feel it. I mean, the president tonight was disappointing when he allowed Mitt Romney to talk about $716 billion in Medicare, and the president did not come out and explain it and go after it. I thought Mitt Romney tonight was in his wheelhouse when he was talking about the economy.
Paul Ryan is cutting $716 from Medicare, the exact same number in his budget, which was passed by the Republican House, and the president never mentioned it. Three or four times he had a bite at that apple, never did.
It does remind you that the last debate that Mitt Romney had was 7 months ago, and the last debate that Barack Obama had was 4 years ago, and the people who he's used to sparring with are reporters who are asking him questions from a seated position as he stands at a lecture.
At 45 minutes, we got asking, how did he prepare? How did the president prepare for this?
We got 45 minutes in before we got a Ryan budget mentioned, which was shocking to me, right? Mitt Romney made the choice to put Romney on the to put Ryan on the ticket. Now, when we look at where in the polls started to separate, they actually start to separate before the convention. They start to separate right around when Ryan is put on the ticket. When do the numbers on Medicare and the polling start to go upside down for the Republicans? They start to go upside down when Ryan is put on the ticket. And yet we get 45 minutes for the debate before Paul Ryan is mentioned. Paul Ryan is the incarnation of the modern Republican Party, which will inherit the power that you give to Mitt Romney, since they will be governing from the House most likely. And so that is the key thing, is to remind people there is a governing arm of the Republican Party that already exists. Mitt Romney is in the position of, it's like nailing Jell-O to a wall, because he can say, well, that's not in my plan. Oh, I don't actually agree with that. No, no, no. You are tied to an actual institutional governing body called the House Republican Caucus, which actually has a record, which actually is going to propose and vote for things that you actually put on your ticket. They are you and you are they. And that connection never really happened.
And it's not in the future. It's not hypothetical. He said if the Ryan plan came to the president, I would sign it.